أتيتك يا خالقي باكيا ودمع الأسى كل حين.
Speaking of the Shahada, brothers and sisters, I've got some excellent news. The organizers have informed me. Thumma alhamdulillah. A sister who attended here today, came here as a non-Muslim, has taken her Shahada today here at the conference. Takbir! Takbir! Brothers, we've had lunch, you can be louder than that. Takbir! That's more like it, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from her, keep her firm upon the deen. Really, subhanAllah, when you speak to brothers and sisters who come into the deen and weren't born into it, you think they don't realize what they've done. Even now they may think they've taken a big step, but they haven't realized what they've done. The truth of what they've done is only going to manifest itself on the Day of Judgment when they stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their limbs shining because of what they did within this dunya by taking the shahada. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us all firm upon the deen and unite us and accept all of our good deeds. Now, just to recap and just inform you of what's to come, we will have another session, inshallah, going forward with Mufti Menk and Sheikh Mansour and Sheikh Naif again. So that is yet to come. But right now, we will proceed with our next lecture, which is titled The Road to Paradise. It will be delivered by Sheikh Sayyid Al-Qadi, who is the General Supervisor of Muntada Trust, and all of us know who Sheikh Sayyid Al-Qadi is, our dear Sheikh. And also, once again, Sheikh Mansour will be with him as well. So without further ado, Fadl Sheikh, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. طيب, I think you've been sitting for a while. Could you please stand up, inshallah, and stretch your muscles, jazakumullah khair. All of you, inshallah. And could you take it further and say salam to each other, inshallah. Beautiful. And say, I love you for the sake of Allah. Make sure the one next to you is the same gender. أنا قلت سلم على بعض يقول حبك في الله بس تأكد أنها نفس الجنس. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah bless your reward. طيب, إن شاء الله, we'll take it very friendly, إن شاء الله تعالى. Sheikh Mansour, may Allah bless him and reward him, his recitation enters the heart. And every time I hear, mashallah, his recitation, it affects me so much. And I hope that we can, all of us, benefit, inshallah ta'ala, from this lecture, which is titled by The Path to Jannah. Before we begin, inshallah ta'ala, say alhamdulillah. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت لك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم لك الحمد كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله علانيته وسره لا يهزم جندك ولا يخلف وعدك سبحانك وبحمدك اللهم صل على محمد. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him, we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one occasion, he left his house, he went to the masjid, he found his companions sitting in a circle doing dhikr. He came to them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked them, why are you gathered? They said, O Messenger of Allah, we are gathered to remember Allah. He said, by Allah, are you only here gather to remember Allah only? They said, by Allah, we are here to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I did not ask you to swear by Allah because I billah your answer. I asked you to swear by Allah because Jibreel alayhi salam came to me a little while ago and told me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is proud of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above his throne is proud of you. May Allah Ta'ala be proud of us. Say Ameen. We all came for the same purpose. We came to remember Allah, the Almighty Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And we ask Allah Ta'ala to remember us and to be proud of us and to bestow His mercy upon us. Say Ameen. And that's why Allah Ta'ala encouraged us to come in a such gathering, in a such place in which we remember Allah, the Almighty. Allah, the Almighty, subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, "Wasbir nafsak."
واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه.
Keep yourself patient with those who remember their Lord by morning and by night. They want the face of Allah. They want the reward of Allah, the countenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا.
And do not let your eye pass beyond them. You want the adornment of this worldly life.
ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا.
And never obey the one whom he have made his heart sealed from our remembrance. And he followed his own desires, and all of his affairs were not aright.
واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا.
Anyone who follows his own desire and his own whims will never have his affairs right. You will only attain happiness once you follow the commandments of Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. The brothers and sisters, let us take you to the hereafter. Imagine that you have passed, or you have managed to pass over the bridge. You have managed to pass the bridge over the hellfire. And now you are before the gates of Jannah, anticipating to reap the rewards of your hard work and patience. If you look behind, you will see the hellfire burning and blazing. And then you will say, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described,
وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ.
And we have removed all hatred from their hearts.
وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارِ.
The rivers are flowing beneath them.
وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ.
They will say, praise be to Allah.
وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَا لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِي لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَا اللَّهِ.
Praise be to Allah. Without Allah's guidance, we would have never reached to here.
لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق.
Indeed, the messengers of Allah came with truth.
ونودوا أن تلكم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون.
And they will be called, come forward, this is Jannah which you have inherited for your good actions and your good deeds. Imagine that you are there and you can see the prophets, the messengers, the companions, and you see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leading them until he reaches to the gate of Jannah. And then he knocks the gate of Jannah. The guard will say, who is this? He will say, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. He will say, yes, I was only commanded to open for you and not to anybody before you. Then he will open the gates of Jannah. Imagine that you are there. You can see the bounties of Jannah. You can see the abode of the everlasting peace and happiness. Such a wonderful sight that eyes have never seen, and ears have never heard, and hearts of human beings have never conceived. You see Jannah which you were promised. Imagine how you're going to be driven to Jannah. Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا.
And those who fear the Lord, they will be driven to Jannah in groups.
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا.
And once they arrive there and they see its gates are open.
وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ.
And its keepers will tell them, will say to them, peace be upon you.
وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ.
Well done, enter and abide in Jannah for eternity, forever. Subhanallah. And as soon as you enter Jannah, you will be able to know your palace in Jannah, your mansion in Jannah, your dwelling in Jannah. You don't need anyone to take you to your kingdom in Jannah. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. I swear by whom my soul in his hand, the people of Jannah, they will know their dwelling in Jannah more than them knowing their dwelling in this life. And then he recited the verse in which Allah ta'ala said,
وَالَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا والذين قتلوا في سبيل الله فلن يضل أعمالهم.
And those who were killed in the cause of Allah Ta'ala, Allah will not cause their actions to go astray.
سيهديهم ويصلح بالهم.
Allah will guide them and give them peace of mind.
ويدخلهم الجنة وَيُدْخِلُهُمُ الْجَنَّةَ عَرَّفَهَا لَهُمْ.
And he will let them enter paradise which he will made known to them. Subhanallah. Imagine that you are there and you can enter Jannah with this way. You are honored and you are filled with happiness. And once you enter Jannah, a caller will call out, as in Muslim, in Sahih Muslim, sound hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a caller will call out. He would say, people of Jannah, people of Jannah, you will have the privilege of living forever and never dying. People of Jannah, you will have the privilege of retaining your youth and never aging. People of Jannah, you will have the privilege of becoming always happy and never facing any misery. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran described his bounties in Jannah, saying, وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةِ
وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ.
And the Jannah will be brought forward for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are mindful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and will not be far from them.
هذا ما توعدون.
This is what you are promised.
هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ.
This promise is for everyone who is oft returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person who keeps returning to Allah and repenting to Allah.
من خشي الرحمن بالغيب وجاء بقلب منيب.
The one who fears Allah ta'ala in secret and he came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a repentant heart. A heart that is returning back to him. A heart is full of remorse and regret from his sins.
ادخلوها بسلام.
Enter Jannah with peace.
ادخلوها بسلام ذلك يوم الخلود.
It's a day of eternity, the day of everlasting peace and happiness.
لهم ما يشاءون فيها.
They will have whatever they want there, whatever they desire, whatever their soul desires, and whatever their hearts or eyes can be content with.
لهم ما يشاءون فيها ولدينا مزيد.
And we have extra for them.
Allah.
What is extra?
Allahu Akbar.
The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, may Allah's peace and blessing be upon him.
Allahu.
He said, when the people of Jannah enter Jannah, Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala will call them. He will say, people of Jannah, are you pleased? They will say, oh Allah, we are pleased. Yes, oh Allah, we are pleased. Why we shouldn't be pleased? And you have given us what you have never given to any of your creation. Allah Ta'ala will say, I will give you something more. They will say, what is more than this? He will say, I will bestow upon you my pleasure. And then I will never be displeased with you at all. Imagine you are in Jannah and Allah Ta'ala is giving you His pleasure, His ridwan in Jannah, and that is forever. You don't worry about Allah's anger or Allah's wrath. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is always pleased with you. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ
وعد الله المؤمنين والمؤمنات.
Allah promised the believing men and women.
وعد الله المؤمنين والمؤمنات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها.
Gardens under which rivers are flowing and they will abide there forever.
خالدين فيها ومساكن طيبة.
And good mansions.
ومساكن طيبة في جنات عدن.
Beautiful mansions in the Garden of Eden.
ورضوان من الله أكبر.
But the pleasure of Allah is far greater.
ورضوان من الله أكبر. ذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
This is the supreme attainment and success that a person can attain. And while the people of Jannah are pleased and happy with Allah's bounties upon them and Allah's pleasures upon them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call them again and He will say, people of Jannah, people of Jannah, they will say, yes, oh Allah, we are at your service. He will say, shall I give you something more? They will say, what is more, oh Allah? Haven't you made our faces bright? Haven't you let us enter Jannah? Haven't you saved us from the hellfire? Then Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, will just remove the veil from his face. And they will see the face of Allah. And nothing in Jannah is more dearer to them than looking at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الذين أحسنوا الحسنى.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة يونس
للذين أحسنوا الحسنى وزيادة.
For those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will have Jannah, paradise, and something more.
وَاللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَى يَقُولُ
وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاضِرًا.
Some faces on that day will beam in brightness.
إلى ربها ناظرا.
Looking at the face of his creator, of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أعظم عذاب, أعظم عذاب لأهل النار أنهم لا يرون الله.
The greatest punishment for the people of the hellfire that they're going to be deprived from looking at Allah's face.
الله عز وجل قال عنهم في سورة المطففين.
Allah تعالى in the chapter of Mutaffifin said about them,
كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون.
Nay, but they will be deprived on that day from looking at Allah's face. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the looking at His face. Say Ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, let's just take now practical steps through which we can attain inshallah ta'ala paradise. We can attain the Jannah which we are all working hard to achieve it or to attain it. The first step is to adhere to the obligations of Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has obliged upon you certain things. And you cannot attain Allah's pleasure without offering Allah's obligations. No matter how much of good deeds you do, if you neglect the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your actions will go astray. Make sure you offer the obligations of Allah Ta'ala upon you. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran described this in a very detailed manner when he said, Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard.
Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard.
Allah Ta'ala is the light of the heaven and the earth.
مثل نوري كمشكات فيها مصباح.
The example of his light is like a niche. Inside it, there is a lamp.
المصباح في زجاجة.
The lamp is inside a glass.
الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري.
The glass is like a shining star.
يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية.
It is lit from a blessed olive tree that is not eastern or western.
يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار.
It's oil is shining even if it's not touching the fire.
نور على نور.
Light upon light.
نور على نور.
Light upon light.
يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء.
Allah guides to his light whoever he wants.
ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم.
And Allah gives the example to people and Allah Ta'ala is the all-knowing.
أين نجد هذا النور؟
Where can we find this light and this guidance?
في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه.
In houses that Allah Ta'ala permitted to be exalted and Allah's name to be remembered in it.
يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال.
Men who glorify Allah Ta'ala there by day and by night.
رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله.
Real men whom their trade or business will never divert them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and establishing the prayer.
وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون.
Their iman will never divert them from remembering that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and establishing the prayer and giving the zakah. They fear a day in which
يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار.
They fear a day in which the eyes and the hearts will turn about.
اللهم اجعلنا من أهل الصلاة.
Say Amen.
Amen.
May Allah bless you and reward you. Another action that will bring us, inshallah ta'ala, closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will ask Sheikh Mansour to mention another reason, inshallah ta'ala. سبب آخر.
طيب هناك سبب آخر إذا عملنا به كلنا في طريقنا إلى الجنة.
It's another action. If you do, we're gonna be on our way to Jannah.
التوبة إلى الله.
Repenting to Allah, the Almighty, Subhanahu wa Taala.
وأنت الآن جالس في مكانك تستطيع أن تتوب إلى الله.
As you are sitting here in your place now, you can repent to Allah, Subhanahu wa Taala.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة مريم.
Allah Taala in chapter of Maryam says,
إلا من تاب.
Except the one who repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إِلَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا.
Except the one who repents to Allah ta'ala and returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and did righteous actions and he believes in Allah.
فَأُولَئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا.
They will definitely enter Jannah and they will never be oppressed.
شيخ سعيد هناك في كتاب الله آية تجعلنا نتوب إلى الله.
There is a verse in the book of Allah Ta'ala that will make us obliged to return back to Allah and to repent to Allah.
يقول فيها ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه.
The companion Abdullah Mas'ud said about it.
هي أرجى آية في كتاب الله.
It is the most hopeful verse in the book of Allah.
إذا قرأها الإنسان.
If a person recites it.
يعود إلى الله.
He will return back to Allah.
ويتوب إلى الله.
And he will repent to Allah.
ويعلم الإنسان أن الله أرحم الراحمين.
And he will know and establish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful.
نريد من الجميع أن يسمعها بتأمل.
We want everyone to listen to this verse with heedful heart and with contemplation, with thinking about it deeply.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم.
Oh my slaves who have transgressed against themselves.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم.
Oh my slaves who have transgressed against themselves.
لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله.
Never despair from Allah's mercy.
لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله.
Never despair from Allah's mercy.
إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا.
Indeed Allah forgives all sins.
إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
He is the most forgiving and the most merciful.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
And the first step that you should take if you want Allah Ta'ala to make you rightly guided is to start by doing what Allah Ta'ala has obliged upon you. Allah Ta'ala obliged upon you the prayer, you offer the prayer. Allah Ta'ala obliged upon you to restrain from usury, riba, and interest, you restrain from them. You restrain from Allah's forbidden things and you adhere to Allah's obligations. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, that he will give guidance, he will give direction for those who abide by his obligations, for those who walk aright.
والذين اهتدوا زادهم هدى وآتاهم تقواهم.
Those who walk aright, those who sought guidance, those who started the first step, they walk aright and they sought guidance, Allah Ta'ala will increase them in guidance.
قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ.
Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides whomever He wants.
وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ أَنَابُ.
And indeed, Allah guides towards him the one who is oft returning, the one who returns to Allah ta'ala constantly, the one who makes repentance a habit in his life.
Sheikh Sa'id, أريد أن أخبرهم بحديث عظيم قدسي عن الله عز وجل.
I would like to tell you a hadith that is said by Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يقول الله عز وجل,
Allah ta'ala the Almighty said,
يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديتم.
O my servants, all of you are misguided except those whom I guided.
فاستهدوني أهدكم.
Seek my guidance, I will give you guidance.
الله عز وجل يقول في هذا الحديث العظيم, يا عبادي,
O my servants,
يا عبادي,
O my servants,
إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار.
You commit sins by day and night. I'm aware of this.
وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا.
And I forgive all sins.
فاستغفروني أغفر لكم.
Seek my forgiveness, I will forgive you.
اللهم اجعلنا من المستغفرين.
اللهم آمين. اللهم آمين. Another action that will bring us closer to Jannah إن شاء الله تعالى is to tie the bonds of kinship. Some people, they may belittle this and think that by doing good deeds and righteous actions and neglecting their relatives and being bad towards them, that they can enter Jannah. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said,
فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ أَن تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَتُقَطِّعُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ.
Do you want then to cause mischief on earth and to sever the ties of your kinship?
أولئك الذين لعنهم الله.
Those whom Allah Ta'ala has cursed.
أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم.
So he made them deaf and blind.
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن.
Can they reflect upon the Quran?
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن.
Can they contemplate the Quran?
أم على قلوب أقفالها.
Or their hearts has been sealed and locked. Brothers and sisters, there is some actions also that will bring or will enable us to enter Jannah with the greatest of ease. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ayyuhal nas, at'imu at'aham, afshu as-salam, silu al-arham, wa sallu bil-layli wa nasu niyam, tadkhulu al-jannata bi-salam. Make sure that you always, as well, you have some actions of good deeds that you do in secret. That you do it when no one can see you but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام. Do an action that no one knows about but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. These kind of actions will come and intercede for you on the day of judgment. Moreover, another action, have or give some attention to the Quran. The Quran will come on the day of judgment and he will intercede for you. He will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, when everyone is naked, when everyone is terrified, everyone is scared, everyone is shocked, everyone is thirsty and hungry, the Quran will come and say, oh Allah, honor him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the garment of honor. Then he will say, oh Allah ta'ala, increase him in honor. Allah ta'ala will give you the crown of honor. And the Quran will keep on interceding for you and arguing for you until you enter Jannah. So the person,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم.
So compete each other in forgiveness from Allah the Almighty subhanahu.
الله عز وجل عندما ذكر الدنيا,
Allah when he mentioned the dunya,
قال في سورة الملك,
he said in the chapter of الملك,
هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا.
He is the one who has made this earth for you easy to agriculture on it.
وعندما ذكر الله عز وجل أمر الصلاة ماذا قال ربي؟
In this chapter he said walk on it.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا.
So when he talked about the dunya, he said walk on it. And when he mentioned the salah, he said run to the salah. Give it priority and give it attention.
وعندما ذكر الله عز وجل الجنة,
and when he mentioned Jannah,
ونعيمها,
and its bounty,
وما أعدها الله عز وجل للصالحين,
and what he has prepared for the righteous people,
قال ربي سبحانه,
Allah the Almighty said,
وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم,
and vie one another or compete with each other,
وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين,
to a forgiveness from Allah Ta'ala and a garden as wide as the heaven and the earth that was prepared for the righteous ones.
فالله عز وجل حقرنا من هذه الدنيا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this life in our sight humiliated. And Allah ta'ala in the Quran when he spoke about this life subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا,
اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب وله,
know that this life is only amusement and entertaining,
وزينة وتفاخر بينكم,
and it's being proud among each other,
وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد,
and you try to increase and to boast of your children and your wealth,
كمثل غيث أعجب الكفار نباته ثم يهيج فتراه مصفرا ثم يكون حطاما وفي الآخرة عذاب شديد لمن ابتعد عن طاعة الله.
So Allah Ta'ala is mentioning that it is the example as of the rain that comes and people expect from it a lot of bounties, but at the end it vanishes away.
ومغفرة من الله ورضوان لمن حقق العبودية في هذه الدنيا.
Whoever worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his heart, Allah ta'ala will grant him forgiveness and paradise.
وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور.
And this life is nothing but a deceiving life. Brothers and sisters, let me give you a practical point to think about. We spoke about the lowest rank in Jannah, the lowest person in Jannah, that lowest person in Jannah who will be given a kingship like the entire world. And Allah Ta'ala will say to him, when he speaks to him, he will tell him that you're going to have a kingship like the entire dunya. He will say, oh Allah Ta'ala, are you making fun of me? He will say, Allah Ta'ala will say, you will have a kingship like the entire dunya, and it's like, and it's like, and it's like, and 10 times it's like, and you will have whatever your heart desire and whatever your eyes can be content with. This is the lowest rank in Jannah. Compare this rank in Jannah, the lowest rank in Jannah, with the hereafter. The lowest rank in Jannah, compare it with dunya, with this life. How long we going to live in this life? How long going to stay in this life? How many years? 70 years? 80 years? If you are lucky, 100 years? Compare that with the hereafter. How long is that? In mathematics, if you want to compare between the dunya and the hereafter, put any number and divide it by the hereafter. Put your age, divided by the hereafter. 80 years, divided by the hereafter. The hereafter is infinity. Any number you divide by infinity, the answer is zero. This life compared to the hereafter is zero. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا
وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ وَلَهُ.
Indeed, this life is only amusement and joy.
وَلَلدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
But indeed, the hereafter is far better for those who fear Allah.
أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ.
Can't you reflect? Can't you think about this? May Allah Ta'ala guide us. And may Allah Ta'ala gather us all in Jannah. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
May Allah bring us all in Jannah together. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
And may Allah increase our iman. And may Allah accept our repentance. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
May Allah bless you. And may Allah reward you. And may Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala accept your repentance and gather us all under his shade, where there won't be any shade by his shade. وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله.
Thanks.
نور على نور.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله. توبة نصوحا.